Hi, I'm Skill Singh, and on this channel, I help you build accessible web applications, cover data science concepts, and share awesome UI and ADA tips and tricks. In our previous videos, we discussed how to make the HTML elements web accessible using HTML5 semantics and Y-area attributes. Please click on this link to learn more. In today's video, we will discuss JAWS, a screen reader that is very commonly used, and the most important hotkeys that you as a developer or a consumer must know. Now, if you are new to this channel, then consider subscribing and smash that like button for more people to see it and develop ADA compliant web applications. Let's first understand what JAWS is. It's a screen reader that is used by people with low vision and blindness to allow them the same access to information as to their sighted peers. This software solution is offered by the Freedom Scientifics team, and you can download their free version from their website. I will provide the link in the description below. NVIDIA is another example of a screen reader that many people use. Let me know in the comment section below in case you want me to make a video on it. Now that we know that what JAWS does, let's discover some of the most commonly used keyboard keys by a screen reader user. Now there are many keyboard keys supported by JAWS, but we will focus on the specific hotkeys that are used day in and day out. I will leave a link in the description below where DQ has shared their quick reference guide. Without further ado, let's discuss the hotkeys. At number 1, we have JAWS starts reading the page as soon as it's loaded. Typically, it reads out the page title, how many headers, regions, and links are present on the page. This is known as the read all mode. You can stop JAWS from reading by pressing the control key. Second, H. It is used to move to the next heading. You can also press number from 1 to 6 to move to a specific heading level like H1, H2, and so on. At number 3, we have R, to move to the next landmark or region on the page. Landmarks such as a header, section, a side, footer, and so on are accessible using the R key press. Next is Q, to move to the main content region where your form or the most important details are present. You can do so by adding a role equals to main attribute to the div. Next is T, to move to the next table. Well, there are many keys pertaining to a table. Please refer to the reference guide in the descriptions below to learn more. Next, we have U, to move to the next unvisited link. Next, we have V, to move to the next visited link. Next, we have a combination of Shift plus H, R, T, U, V to move back to the previous heading, region, and so on. Next, we have Tab keys, which are used to read the next focusable item like link, button, or a checkbox. Next, we have Shift plus Tab to move back to the previous focusable item. Next, we have Enter key to activate the link or a button. Next, we have Spacebar to make a selection among checkboxes or radio buttons or to activate a button. Finally, we have Arrow keys to move to the next element or to toggle between radio buttons, drop downs, menu buttons, and so on. As a developer, you need not cram them all. You can download a reference guide from the description. Now that you have made it so far, please help me by clicking on the like button and share this video with your friends to help them build a web accessible application to make their content available to all. Well, that's it. We just discovered the most commonly used keyboard keys by the JAWS users. Please comment on which element I should make in the next video. Till then, keep coding.